Coach, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Lone Star State and the very mammoth AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. A moment ago, here was the scene with the Cowboys emerging from their tunnel. It was loud. It's still loud. We're ready for football as the Cowboys get set to match up with the New York Giants. Dan Bailey's got it teed up, and here we go now from Arlington at AT&T Stadium. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Is Saquon Barkley. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield.
Well, add that play to his resume, Real, because he went to the Pro Bowl last year. That's how you go to the Pro Bowl. You make plays like that, big-time penetration, and throw people for losses.
Now Manning throwing on second down. Over the middle to Smith. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves his sticks. Manning now on first down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Manning to throw on second down. It's caught. Back. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. And now the Cowboys are going to call another timeout. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to one remaining. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. Now Manning on the bootleg. He'll get this out to Barkley, complete. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Calling a gain of 10, and they pick up the first. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
Now a first carry for Jonathan Stewart. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. Manning to throw on second down. Flushed out right. It's hauled in by Shepherd. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It's the first time that they've looked his way tonight, and he comes up with a first down on the play. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10, down at the 33. The first down carry for Barkley. And he will cross the 30 down to the 29-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback, makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
On second down, here's Manning. And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack. Malik Collins continuing to fight downfield. The big tackle gets him for a loss of 11. Third and long for the Giants, and Eli following the sack. Throwing is Manning. And this is going to be incomplete.
As my dad used to tell me all the time, when you're getting ready to play a big-time game, especially when you have one going into a dome setting, better strap it up tight, because that crowd can really affect things.
Especially on third downs like the one we just saw there with the incompletion. Fourth down, so on is the punter, Riley Dixon. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at the 20.
Go 46. Go, go, go. Get out there, get out there.
A first down throw for Prescott. And his first look is incomplete.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Prescott again, and this time he's got the hookup. It's complete, and they're able to get this one across the 35. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And this one hauled in by Tavon Austin. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Awesome.
First down, Prescott. Eluding the pressure right. Finding room inside the 40. On the right side, this is Austin with a catch. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
So the drive takes them into Giants territory now, first and 10 at the 36.
Here you go. Sweat. 47. Here we go, 46. Gun. 26.
Prescott looks to throw on first. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
Here we go. 46.
A second down throw for Prescott. And that is incomplete.
Chances are good he's going to be a very busy guy. Two catches already in this opening drive, and they were looking his way for a third.
I think they put this defense on notice that that could be a really, really frequent combination.
Yeah, baby. Yeah.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10.
Here we go, 46. 26.
They'll throw again. Prescott. And incomplete here on third down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. To the air again, Prescott. And he's got it to Burns. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That one good for 17 yards on fourth. Couldn't ask for much more from your offense there. First down. First opportunity in the red zone for the Cowboys. First and 10 at the 19.
Let's go, get out.
from the red zone now. Prescott, they'll set up the screen to Elliott. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It's a loss of five there, bringing up second. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it at the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open.
So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long.
Here goes 48. Here goes 46. Here goes 46. Here goes, get that. Let's go. Get out. Get out.
They just get the playoff. Now Prescott. Over the middle, he hits Austin. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. 19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it first and goal. Two minutes remain in a scoreless first half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. This one back to the 5 yard line, but no further than that. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. One man in the backfield, that's Elliott on second and goal. Now it's a bootleg with Prescott. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Connor Barwin leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of six.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football, had to eat it, and ended up on the ground.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long.
Switch and A. Switch and A.
And with the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal?
Gun.
Check 93 is the mic. 93 is the mic.
26.
Check 93 is the mic. 93 is the mic.
Switch and A. 26.
Prescott on third and goal. And a Pressure gets to him again. And now the Giants will stop play as they take a timeout defensively, as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. The Cowboys will turn it over now to Dan Bailey for the field goal try. From the left hash, it's a 36-yard attempt. And Bailey able to knock it through. And the Cowboys are going to jump out to a 3-0 lead. So they get the field goal, but that was a 14-play drive to get three.
It sounds like you're going negative on that.
I was.
Sounds like you're thinking the three is just not that good.
And people say that we're negative sometimes. So.
Well, here's the deal. Getting the three is good. Obviously, you would think on a 14-play drive you're going to get six out of it. But that type of a drive could pay dividends later on because you might wear the defense down.
Here's the Giant offense now making their way back out onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They'll start out on the ground at Saquon Barkley. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. To throw on second down, Manning, and incomplete there. A nice hit, jars the ball free, and brings up third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. On third and long, it's Manning. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. A gain of four on the play. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. And that's going to make it fourth down. And likely time for one final play here in the half, so they will go for it on fourth down. One final try now for Manning. He's going to let this one go deep. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 19. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And just like that, on we head to half number two. These offenses seemingly still back at the hotel for the first half. 3-0 our score as the second half gets underway. That's fielded in the end zone. And he is out of bounds here on the return. Out come the Cowboys now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal. And I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not out and out joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
Yeah, maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Prescott on first down. Stepping up, he'll try and run, and he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and 1 yard.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it, and he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
go. Let's finish now.
All right, guys, double tight. We got three. We got three, fellas. We got three.
Here we go. 46. 46.
Check. 93 is the mic. 93 is the mic.
Here we go. 46. 46.
Switch.
Just air. 46.
Second down. Prescott. And we'll find his man on the outside. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains. First and 10, Prescott. And the giant rush gets home as down he goes. Olivier Vernon in there to sack him for a loss of 6. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on 2nd and 16.
Switch and 8. 47.
A second down throw for Prescott. Got it open, man. It's Michael Gallup. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. That one goes for 24 yards. So the drive takes them into Giants territory now, first and 10, right at the 40.
Here we go, get that, let's go, get out.
Here we go, T.
Here we go, 46. Here we go, 46.
The first down carry by Elliott. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Now they'll look to throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. B.J. Goodson coming in hard on the blitz. He gets him down for a loss of 4. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Back now in Arlington. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle.
Here you go. Good. You go 46, 46, 47. Switch it.
Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. And a hit jarring it loose. It's incomplete. First quarter, Charles, you really emphasized the importance of winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. They haven't forced a single turnover in this game.
And right now they're losing, so no turnovers might lead to no victory.
Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long.
Here we go, 46. Sweat.
Looking to throw, Prescott steps away to his left. He may try and run for this, and he'll slide down to avoid the contact. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. And Bailey able to knock it through. And that will add three more to their lead. It pushes it up to six. So they get the three, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now because they'd feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. And New York set to take the field. The result's not great thus far. A punt on the first drive and an interception last time out.
Now, let's face it. Every team wants to come out on the field and play with some confidence, play with some tempo, play with some rhythm. And when you're making those types of mistakes, you're not getting any of that put together.
So what do you say, time to get back to the basics for them?
In a lot of ways, yes, but the biggest one, of course, is finding people who will take care of the football and make a few plays. You've got to have a drive now that calms down the entire team.
27 to Sam. Zebra.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Being chased out left. He'll get this out to Barkley, complete. And he's able to get up here to the 26. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Manning now on first down. Barkley on the check down. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. It's a gain of six on the play, and it'll be second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
To throw is Manning. The man right side is Ingram. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. call it a gain of seven, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Zebra.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup, and that'll make this a second down. Shotgun now for Manning. He dumps it off to Barkley. They'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to a third down. Now, the old pass completion for no gain, not something you want to call up out of the playbook too often.
Yeah, most offensive coordinators don't have that on their play sheet, so they've got to go back and scramble after this one. But right now, with what they're telling receivers about making sure you take care of the ball in open field, sometimes the fighting for extra yardage doesn't come as a result. That and good tackling lead to no yards gained.
Manning gonna throw. He'll complete this to Ingram, his tight end. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. So down six, and they know they need this one on fourth down. They'll run for it with Barkley, and this winds up a disaster nowhere near the marker. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. They run. This is Scarborough, and he'll take this one down to about the 40. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Is going to run out here. They're in no hurry to get a playoff. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
Prescott here to throw, and incomplete there. A nice hit, jars the ball free, and brings up third down.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams, and there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
The Cowboys on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 14.
46.
Prescott. And he comes back with one complete. And now the Giants will stop play as they take a timeout defensively, as they get the stoppage with 65 seconds remaining. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a two-score game. And Bailey able to knock it through. And that will make our score 9-0. So barring something extraordinary here in the closing stages, that field goal should just about put this one on ice.
Yeah, we've got to find two scores. So, you know, we're not going to exactly move it over there yet. It can be done, but, boy, it's going to be a little bit of a stretch for them, isn't it?
Yeah, they would have to move incredibly quick and have some luck, too. And he'll get it up just past the 20, and his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. And the Giants ready to come out now. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly, then they'll take it from there.
Now Manning. And that's going to be incomplete. Jeff Heath, the strong safety, able to get in there on the coverage. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Zebra, zebra.
To throw is Manning. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. So they took a shot there on third down. Couldn't get it. Now it's four.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Now Manning, gotta have this one. And he will go down, a Cowboys sack. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one.
Here we go, 46. Done. Gun.
Throwing here, Prescott. And he's brought down. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal.
Here we go, here we go. I'm going to 54, going to 54. Wide eight. Here you go.
Here we go, T. Here I come.
Here we go, get out. Get out.
They'll try to run it in with Elliott. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
So statistically, both of these offenses have a rough time getting a running game going. But boy, what a nice play there defensively.
Tackling him behind the line, but you're right. You look at the numbers, neither side looks on track in the ground game. This is third and goal, and this Giants defense, they have withstood the test thus far.
Here we go, 46. Here we go, 46. Gun.
Prescott to throw. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Tavon Austin. A 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Cowboys will extend their lead.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Dan Bailey now for the extra point. Extra point up and good by Bailey. And that could be important as that makes this a 16-point lead. Bailey now to kick this one away. This will be taken short. Oh, he's going to take this out of the back of the end zone. And that's going to be a safety. And Charles, at some point, you can't keep worrying about big play. Can this be perfect? You just have to get the ball out of the end zone.
And in the offensive huddle, that was discussed when they called the play. Just get out of the end zone. But you know what's interesting? A lot of the times in the defensive huddle, they actually call a set and then say at the end of it, get a safety. So it's preached, it's coached, it's thought about.
After the safety, remember, they also need to give up the football, and here's the free kick. Fair catch called for and made at about the 32-yard line. Now the Cowboys' offense heads back onto the field. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now. They'll put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. And they'll get to this and touch it. Looks like, yeah, right at the 15-yard line here. So Charles are able to complete what so often seems to be elusive, a shutout in the NFL. And maybe what's fitting is they ended the game on the field, that defensive unit on the field. What an exclamation mark.
And probably felt like they could go another 60 minutes without anyone putting points on the board against them. That's the confidence you gain throughout when you're pitching a shutout. And they're going to leave the stadium feeling like they're all 10 feet tall.